Now what you guys are seeing in front of you on the screen is probably the most efficient desktop configuration ever. Conditions applied. Now on the first glance it might seem like just a wallpaper for most people, but on the second glance you can of course go ahead and then see stuff which is hidden behind it. There are some stuff which you probably expect in a panel like an application menu, which is not there in this panel. At the same time, there are some stuff which you probably don't expect in the panel, like window title, which already exists in this panel. Now I'm gonna come back to why I have this in a minute. Okay, with all of that done with the panel, let's just get started with how a window looks. So as you can see, this is a typical window in my heavily configured desktop. Now with that said, let me go ahead and then open up the launcher. So this is the launcher. It's not Albert, it's not U Launcher, it is KRunner. Now most of you guys are used to seeing KRunner right here at the top, but most of you guys also probably don't realize that KRunner can also be made to go ahead and then launch in the center rather than on the top. You know, this just looks way cooler and way better than Spotlight. And not to mention, this is literally Spotlight, but it has more features, considering that you can not only pin, you can also ask for help, you can search the web, you can. Now let me go ahead and then open up a specific window. Now as you guys can see, yes, I am editing the video which you guys are seeing right now simultaneously as I am also recording this. Yes, I am a genius. Now as you guys can see, I have the full privilege to actually go ahead and then enjoy KDEN Live by default completely full screen without the panel coming in the way and covering the screen. Now coming to the file manager, Dolphin looks great, considering that there is a very glassy, really good looking sidebar right here with that background blur which shows the wallpaper partially, and that amazing rounded corners in the selected. Not to mention the font, which is also completely changed. The layout in general also just looks awesome. Well, it's the default layout, but the font, the design, the theme. And with that said, we will go ahead and then jump into the next part of this video, which is showing you how you guys can do this. Okay, so now is the right time to say more than 95% of you guys have not subscribed this channel. I mean, you guys are missing out on a lot of content. Go ahead, hit that subscribe button. It really helps both of us. And yeah, on with the video. Now, step one, go ahead and then just delete the launcher. You don't want the launcher because you are using Alt space and then you just want the KRunner to be your default launcher. KRunner is way better than the normal launcher which you have right here. Second step, move this panel to wherever you want. In my case, I have moved it to the top. Third one, go ahead, increase the number of workspaces you have. You do that by saying virtual desktops and then go ahead and then add how many ever virtual desktops you want. In my case, I have selected 4 virtual desktops. And finally, go ahead and then decrease the size of the panel to something more sensible, because by default, I don't know why KDE Plasma does this, but making it better, just go ahead and then make it smaller. With all of that said, I also would like to add one more thing. Go ahead and then right click onto this clock icon, this clock widget right here, and then just say configure digital clock, and then change this from adaptive location to always beside time. That is gonna go ahead and then place the date beside the time, making it more visible for you and then just making your life easier. And finally, go ahead and then right click onto the panel, go ahead, add some widgets, get new widgets, download new Plasma widgets, title, and then install window title applet by whatever that is. Once the widget is finally installed, go ahead, add the widgets, just say title and then drag and drop it to the panel. I'm not gonna drag and drop because I already have the widget with me. So once you have done that, congratulations, you have the panel ready. Once you have that done, it is now time to go ahead and then configure KRunner. Now by default, you're gonna have this KRunner at the top somewhere right here. What you want is to have it at the center. At least what I assume you want is you want to have this at the center, because I have the panel at the top and I don't want the panel and the launcher to be at the top. So for that, I'm just gonna go ahead and then say alt space by default to open up the KRunner, and then go to this small configure KRunner button. It's gonna be top by default. All I have to say is choose center, and then now I have KRunner working at the center. And yes, by the way, if you think Albert or ULauncher or any other application like that is better when it comes to Spotlight alternatives in Linux, trust me, KRunner is way better than them, with the disadvantage that it works only for KDE. Let's move on to the interesting part of the configuration. Let's go to the system settings and then change some appearance right here, because that is what matters at the end of the day. Go ahead to the global theme and then install Mo Dark using the Get Global Themes button. But once you have Mo Dark or whatever that is installed, you can just go ahead, select that, and then hit apply. Make sure you have this option disabled, because you don't want that to be enabled. And this leads us to the next thing, which is the lightly command. Go ahead and then open up your terminal and just go ahead and then say sudo dnf install lightly, and then hit enter if you are using a Fedora based distribution. But most of you guys probably are not using Fedora based distribution. For all of you guys, just go ahead and then say lightly KDE or something like that, and then just install lightly theme, which is a KDE theme, and it really looks good. Just go ahead and then install that from the GitHub repositories. If you are using something like Ubuntu or Ubuntu based distribution, you probably have to go ahead and then compile it from scratch, which is not rocket science, but it is fairly difficult. Just go ahead, follow this installation procedure, and then that should be able to install the lightly theme for you. And by the way, lightly is the reason why I get this blur effect in Dolphin. Now once you have lightly applied, you can go to plasma style and then install whatever you want. In my case, I went ahead and then installed a plasma theme called Relax Plasma, and then yeah, it looks fairly good. So when it comes to colors, go ahead and then say a custom color. You can also go ahead and then just choose any one of these preset colors. In my case, I'm just gonna go ahead and then choose this color right here, which seems to be the mix of purple and violet. Okay, it's purple. So just go ahead and then choose this color, and then that should be done. And when it comes to window decorations, this is what makes my windows so minimal. Go ahead and say get new window decorations, and then just go ahead and then say something like one dark or something like that. That should show you the window decoration which I installed. Inside fonts, all you have to do is that replace all the fonts with Source Code Pro, and that will give you this, you know, nerdy style font, which is actually good looking for me. In my case, Linus Tech Tips chose a very, very unusual font. So yeah, it highly depends on you and what font you need. In my case, this font was really good looking, so I went with Source Code Pro. You can even leave it with the default fonts if you want. So yeah, once you are done with the fonts, go with the icons. And in my case, I just went with the Breeze Dark icon theme because, well, it looks good by default. And when it comes to the cursor, I went with the White Sir cursors, which look fairly good and is more Mac OS like. I'm not trying to copy Mac, but it just looks good. Once that is done, go to this plus screen, and even I have to do this myself. Maybe I'm just gonna look out for something good. Okay, so I'm just gonna go with this splash screen right here. The icon right here of Fedora is fairly old. Coming to the wallpaper collection or the wallpapers, whatever you want to choose, I mean, it really depends on you, but in my case I just went with the GitLab repositories of DistroTube. I know you guys watch DistroTube. I know the analytics of my channel, and I know most of you guys out there who watch this channel also watch DistroTube. Yeah, this is the wallpaper collection which I use right now. Just go ahead and then clone this repository into your wallpaper collection, and that's it. You are done with the wallpapers. And this is my personal workflow. Let me know what you guys think about it. Now, of course, I'm still working on this interface. This is, of course, not the best interface in the world, but I'm making it better, and eventually it probably can be a fairly good interface for most people. With that said, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Leave a like so that YouTube knows you're enjoying what you're watching. Subscribe so that you're gonna get all my videos, and I will meet you in the next video. Goodbye.